we gather together 1,000 strong tonight, the last night of a great administration. Let's all thank Barack Obama for all he has done for this nation. Tomorrow, there will be a peaceful transfer of power. Tomorrow, Donald Trump will have power. But tomorrow, you will have power as well. Donald Trump may control the agenda in Washington, but we control our destiny as Americans. And tonight is an example of people coming together to make clear what we believe is the future of our country and how we will fight for it. Remember, the country doesn't reside in Washington, D.C. It's every city, it's every town in America where change is made. And we are resolute that we will keep making our cities and our towns better, regardless of who's in Washington, D.C. Now, my friends, we're here tonight, and we should not let anyone define us just by what we're against. We want to be defined by what we are for, what we believe in. We believe in health care for all. We believe there should be opportunity for people regardless of what they look like or where they come from. We believe in a society for the 99%, not just the 1%. We believe in healing the wounds between our police and our community and making us all safer together. And we believe in protecting our precious earth from the scourge of climate change. And we can do something about it in every city and town in America while we fight the fights in Washington, D.C. Right now, here in New York and all over the country, people are getting together to sign up their fellow Americans for health care under the Affordable Care Act because it is still the law of the land in this country. And you can help to get more and more people insured, to help protect their families, and to make it harder to ever take away the right to health care in this country. Here in New York City, join our Get Covered NYC campaign to make sure that more and more New Yorkers have the health care they deserve. Join our efforts to sign up New Yorkers for IDNYC, regardless of who you are, where you come from. You're a New Yorker, and we honor and respect you. And we stand together in making sure there is no discrimination, there is no hatred in our city or any city. If you see a hatred, an act of hatred, if you see a bias crime, report it immediately. Stand up against hatred. Today, we recognize that we are building something. You know, Donald Trump always liked to say he built a movement. Well, now it's time for us to build our movement. And that starts tonight, and it's all over the country. Tonight, tomorrow, in the days to come, a movement building to protect all the gains we've made and protect the rights of our people. My friends, mayors are gathering from all over the country in a common cause. They've signed a pledge to defend the progress we've made, to make sure our cities and towns represent the best of America, from one part of this nation to the other, from the Liberty Bell to the Gateway Arch, from the Great Salt Lake to the banks of the Rio Grande River. Mayors all over the country are signing this pledge for common action, that the next 100 days will be days of action together. And we are standing up for our cities and we are standing up for our towns because our cities and our towns are the authentic America, are the open and compassionate America, are the hopeful America. Some people think we're going to be dejected. Some people think we're going to be in a state of mourning. We're just going to shirk away from playing any role in our nation. Well, no. Tomorrow we begin to organize. Tomorrow we gather together. Look at the thousands here tonight, and this is only a beginning. We don't fear the future. We think the future is bright if the people's voices are heard. And my friends, we're going to fight together. We are going to fight together. From Seattle to Santa Fe, from Boston to Birmingham, Alabama, people are joining together right now for a country that respects all its people, values all its people, provides opportunities for all, protects the health care of all, protects the environment for all. That is what we are fighting for. And tomorrow, my friends, tomorrow is not an end. Tomorrow is a beginning. Get ready to build the nation we always believed in together. And now I get the great pleasure of introducing a dynamic, progressive leader from the heartland of our nation, the mayor of Minneapolis, Minnesota, Betsy Hodges.